Excel's a workhorse. It's everywhere, in business, schools, even startups. But what if you take all the power of Excel, combine it with Python, and supercharge it with AI, all in one place? Hey, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I'll show you five ways that Quadratic might be the smarter choice, especially if you work with data, love automation, or want to bring AI into your spreadsheet workflows. Reason number one is the AI. It's so easy to use in Quadratic. You can use it for things like data analysis, creating charts, even creating the sample data, which I'm going to show you in a moment. I could go and upload a file or even create a connection to get data, but I'm going to use the AI. Notice they even have a prompt right here. If you want to test this out and do the exact same thing I'm doing, there's a link down below. You can log in, create an account with Quadratic and test this out for free. I'm going to go and give it this prompt right here. Create sales data for four different regions, have five different products with four salespeople and 20 entries. It's going to create a table for me with this entry. Then I can do some data analysis with it to show you how easy it is to create a thing like a pivot table or even charts to go with it. So let's start with a pivot table on this. I want to look at the top sales regions in a pivot table. So I'm going to say create a pivot table for top, top regions. So just with a prompt, it will go through and notice what it's using here. It's using Python, and I'm going to come back to that for another reason to pick what Quadratic. And we have our pivot table right here created. Notice how I can move this around. Now I probably want to go to through another step and visualize this as well. Or maybe I want to even break down, do I want region and product analysis, or do we just want a visualization? So if I click on the visualization, it's going to go, it's creating a bar chart to visualize. I could tell it whatever type of chart I'd want it to create. And then we have it right here. So I could go, if I didn't like blue, I could tell it to be, let's say, red. I'll say, turn it to red, like that. And you're gonna see that it rewrites the Python to turn this to red. So when you're looking at if you need data to create to practice, you can go and start analyzing just by asking questions with this. You don't have to know much about spreadsheets just to prompt it, and it will go and create the information using AI. In reason number one, I was focused on AI. But really what makes Quadratic special is AI and Python working together within a spreadsheet. Unlike Excel, which primarily relies on VBA or external tools and our add-ons for advanced scripting, Quadratic allows you to write and run Python directly within the spreadsheet cells. So in any cell, if I just go /, notice how I have quick access to the languages. I'll click on Python where we have our coding window. We even have a console here for print statements and where our AI works, where we can get it to just with a prompt to write the code for us. Let's work through a little example here so you can see Python in action in Quadratic. All right, so here I've got my sales data in Quadratic, and I'm going to ask the AI assistant to help me group by sales and region. So down here, and notice the information is going to go into this cell because that's where I'm located. So group sales by region and sum them. Now you're going to see the code get created up top here, and I'm going to get a chance to accept it or reject it. So here it is. Here's the code from here. I'll accept it. And this is what it created. Now, let's do a little bit more with it. Like before, when it created the chart, I can go ahead and run it from here. And now the chart, you'll see how it gets created inside Python here. Again, with Plotly here, I'm going to accept it. And if I close out of it here, you'll see how it replaced the other one because I was in the same cell. At any time, if I want to back open the code again, if I just drop down here, open in code editor, this is where you could make any changes to your code. Okay, let's take it one step further now. I'm going to ask it to build a predictive model to forecast sales. So I noticed this time, 67 lines here. We did get an error. Is it going to fix it? It's going to notice that there was an error in the data type conversion. So it did go ahead and fix it. I'm going to accept it. And I'll close out of this so we can see what was created. Here is the sales forecast here. We have our historical, then the forecast, and the confidence interval in there. Reason number three. Let's talk about getting external data into your spreadsheet. We often need live info from company databases or real-time data from web APIs, right? But manually exporting, importing, or copying, pasting is slow, tedious, and prone to errors. Now, Excel can connect to external data sources. You typically go through the data tab, click get data, choose your source like a database or web, and then often work your way through connection wizards and maybe even Power Query to shape the data. It's powerful, yes, but it can involve several steps, separate windows, and isn't always the most direct route. This is where Quadratic offers a fundamentally different approach. Instead of navigating menus, you can write SQL queries or Python code directly inside a spreadsheet cell to fetch the data you need. I want to show you how quickly you can connect an API inside Quadratic. And I'm going to use this as an example right here, just this oil price API. I'm just going to copy this over. Now, I'm going to use the AI to help me with this. So I'm just going to go to this and say, place the following in as API. And I'm just going to give it that information. And you'll see right away, it's going to go fetch that oil price from here. So right here, here's the time, the timestamp, and the price. And let's say I want a little bit more data from there. Let's go add more price data points, and it will go and fetch that. So if I go through, I'm just going to expand this open so you can see the timestamp. Now I have a few different times on this. And like I showed you before, I could use AI to create these different charts for this here based on the data that was fetched from the API. Reason four, beyond standard charts, Quadratic allows creating more advanced, dynamic, or even animated visualization using AI prompts or by leveraging integrated Python libraries like Plotly. Let me show you an example here. All right, let me show you how easy it is to make an interactive chart. I'm just back on my crude oil where I got it from the API and I extended the price points to go back a year. I'm just going to tell it to make this into an interactive chart. Now I could give more specifics, but I just want to show you even by giving it that, it's going to go ahead and create, and it will let me know what are all the different interactive points within it. So I can see the Python code here. We have the chart being created. I'm just going to look at some of the points over here, hover over the data points to see exact values. So if I go click into it, I'll move this up. If I click into it, if I hover over, you can see the exact points in this one. I can pan across the different time periods, and I can click and drag into different points too to zoom up on it. So just by giving it that little bit of information, it was able to create an interactive chart and try to do that in the same thing with Excel that easily. You won't be able to do it. We've all been there, right? Waiting for that huge spreadsheet to load in your browser, or trying to scroll through thousands of rows only to have it stutter and lag. Performance, especially with large data sets and web-based spreadsheets, can be a real pain point. Traditional web technologies sometimes struggle to render and compute massive amounts of data efficiently. This is an area Quadratic aims to improve significantly, and it comes down to how it's built under the hood. Quadratic leverages a stack of modern web technologies. It uses WebGL for rendering the spreadsheet grid. That's the same tech often used in gaming for fast hardware-accelerated graphics. It also uses WebAssembly and Rust to run computation-heavy code efficiently right within your browser. So what does all this tech talk actually mean for you, the user? It means potentially faster loading times, smoother scrolling and zooming, even with very large files, and more responsive calculations. The goal is to make work with big data in the web browser feel less sluggish and more like a native desktop application. Now, let's be clear. Desktop Excel running locally on your machine is often very fast. It has direct access to your computer's resources. But when we compare web-based spreadsheets like Excel Online or Google Sheets, they can sometimes hit performance limits with demanding tasks or massive data sets. So that's a quick look at five ways Quadratic can offer a different kind of experience compared to Excel. From using Python right inside your spreadsheet to getting you help from AI and building charts quickly. It's a tool worth checking out, especially if you're working with data regularly. If you're curious to try it out yourself, there's a link in the description where you can explore Quadratic and see how it fits into your workflow.